Whoa. I don't think so, my dude. Damn right. Oh shit. Another one. Ooh. There we go, there we go. You can do this. Take it. Go again. Down. Fuck. So many. Oh, this one's got a shield. Oh, fuck. Okay, okay. Making it interesting. Okay, I'm getting too reckless.
It's nearly over.
I don't think so. Man, that was intense. All the blood. Valraven.
Valraven, ancestor of the seers and master of ravens. He hunts his prey with his powers of illusion and feasts on their remains. Mark, the gate to Helheim cannot be opened without it.
Shit. All right, let's do this. Hmm. What is this?
Ymir was a frost giant, a being of darkness. And all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice, Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods, the Old Father.
That's pretty cool. Going over Old Norse mythology. Boom. Jump right over it, homegirl.
Hides the path to Valravn. Don't trust your eyes. Find another way to see the truth.
Interesting. Okay. Wonder what this gimmick is. The voices, they're kind of cute at times. They're like, she did it. Wide open area, a fight maybe?
This is the price she pays for seeing things differently. Because once you gaze into the relentless darkness, all that lurks within it can see you too.
One of the voices said I'm in danger. Be afraid. The voices are actually useful. Let's go. Shit. Get up, girl, get up. Out there. What? Come on. There we go. Whew. Got hit a couple times, but that's fine. That's fine.
The Northmen will not stop her. She will find what she's looking for.
Ooh. Okay. Let's go. Just looking around.
Valravn's power of illusion comes from ravens, allowing the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Truth. Look how much it's changed.
Not sure if I understand this.
Break the seal, align the ravens with the mark of Valravn.
I'm confused. So do it from this way, maybe? I don't know. Where's the thing? It's not even showing the thing on my screen anymore. Huh. Whoa. Whoa. Wait a damn minute. son of a bitch. Son of a bitch. That's crazy. That is cool as fuck. Now I see what the purpose of that was. Okay. Oh, there's more. I got it.
It's not safe. Don't listen to them. Listen, don't. Open. You can do it. Don't.
To break the seal, align the ravens with the mark of Valravan.
Where are they? What does it mean? One of the ravens. Which ravens? Where are they? Can't you see them? She can't see
them. These voices. Oh my god. I wonder if that's what it's like to hear voices. Cause damn. This area looks like it can get kind of confusing. Hmm. This is certainly different. I should open that one too, I think. There we go. Hell yeah. Got him.
What is it?
I hear something.
If you hear the soul of Van Raven, follow it, and it will lead you to him. But be aware of his illusions. You can't always trust your eyes.
Yo, this is some crazy shit.
We picture fear, and we think of a shadow in the woods, a creature in the night. If only it were that simple. The worst kind comes without warning. A deep and primal signal from within. A reminder that just because you cannot see the threat, it doesn't mean that it's not already here.
Damn. Let's look over here. Whoa, shit, that scared me. That legit made me jump. Oh, come on. Can't believe that fucking made me jump, dude. Oh, come on. Get up, girl. Get up, get up, get up, get up. Oh, come on. I'm in a corner. It won't let me get out. Shit, shit. Got him. Come on. Okay, got him. Got him. Okay, okay. This is really rough. Oof. Really, he's pounding his shield. Jesus, this guy is so tough. Holy shit, are you serious? There we go. There we go. Goodness, that was intense. Holy shit. Okay, I came from there.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return.
That does sound pretty rough.
Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
Where in the hell are we? What are we supposed to be doing? What the hell?
She thought she could beat her own darkness.
Did she beat her darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillion.
She came to beat her own darkness and marry Dillion.
But
she thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him. She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too. She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
What's different here? I'm so confused.
The Northmen say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated the sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung.
Yeah, I think now it's just finding out where to go. Shouldn't be too big of a deal, though. Oh, nice. That's actually quite clever. I see. Yeah, that's not gonna work.
The Northmen say that Odin is always in search of knowledge and wisdom and magic. There was a very wise being named Mimir who guarded the waters of wisdom which flow from the roots of the world tree. Odin wished to drink from this spring, but he had to pay a price. So he gouged out his own.
That is legit clever. I really like that. Now we just go in the front door. Valrathin' my ass.
the ravens.
The ravens?
They've gone.
They've gone.
No.
Half of them have gone.
They've gone. Some are still there.
But where?
Some are still
there.
The Vile Raven's helping. Where's he?
He's not helping.
It's a trick.
Quiet. Try. Can't think.
Out in the wilds. In the cold winter woods.
Where?
She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. But she remembered Ilian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become part of her.
I think I see. This is like a very elaborate puzzle. Holy shit. What is this supposed to do? Oh. I think I see. Got it.
There is no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. It's like it doesn't want to kill her. Yet, I'll gnaw at her, biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strive to kill. Will she find Dillian before her time comes?
That's a good question. Here, I want to turn a couple things down just a little bit. What's this? There we go. What'd that say? Shit. Not low, just high. Cool. Let's go. Aston, I'm here for you. Asshole. Okay, let's see what this is all about. Oh wow. Okay.
Speak to me, Drew. Tell me a story.
Senua, listen. I will tell you the tale of a man called Findan. The Northmen captured Findan's sister, and his father sent him to pay for her release. But they took his gold, put him in chains, and held him for a day and a night without food or water. Then they released him. I don't know why. Upon his return, his father's enemies in Erin set fire to his home. His father burnt to death, and his brother was killed. But he escaped with sorrow in his heart. His father's enemies offered redress for his loss and invited him to a feast. It was at a hall near the sea. When he went there, they betrayed him to the Northmen, who enslaved him and took him to hell.
Damn.
6 years later, his slave masters landed on the shores of Orkney, burning all before them. And into that fire, Findan made his escape. What was Findan? Burnt away that day. But from the flames, a new man stepped forward, and Druth was born. Druth, the man that I am now. And though Findan never set eyes on his dear sister again, I, Druth, have found you, Senua.
That's a cool story. I think I see what I gotta do. I don't think so. I think I did the illusion thing incorrectly. Okay, let's try that. There we go. We got this. We got this. It's cool. It's cool. There we go. Got him.
Broken. The gate is open. Open. It's darkness. I know it from the wilds. It's coming back for me.
Oh, shit.
I'm still here. Are you too? Where are we? I remember.
didn't end well in the wilds. It never does. You think you can overcome the darkness, make sense of it. And once relief settles in, struck down now, throwing you helplessly back into the maelstrom, drowning the mind in fear, deeper, deeper, driving you down so far into the void that maybe this time there is no coming back. But there, in the darkness, and she remembered what he told her.
Hear me. Reach out to me. Senua, take my iron mirror. Look into it, for it is a window into the underworld. Within, you will see the face of the darkness that you fear. And if you focus, like I have taught you to, you will also see that as much as the darkness has you trapped within its veil, it too is trapped within yours. Focus. Focus.
Get it.
Focus.
I see you. I see you now. You led me to the wilds. You trapped me there.
I don't think so, dog. Shit. Fuck you, man. Come on.
She's injured, but she can still do it. It's not on.
Come on, dodge. Come on, why is she not dodging? Get out of there. Shit. Are you supposed to dodge that?
Can't do it.
What? I was dodging. Come on. Come on. Son of a bitch. Come on. How?
Stop them.
Shit. Ah, fuck you, man. Get up, get up, get up, get up, get up. Second one. Damn. The amount of concentration this is requiring is just insane.
Behind you!
fucker. Come on. Come on now. Holy shit. Yes.
Valravn, one of the keys to the gate to Helheim. Hold it in your mind's eye.
With every battle, the darkness grows stronger. Every victory, bringing her closer to defeat. Unfair, isn't it? In those dark winter nights in the wilds, there were times when she considered letting go. If it weren't for truth, a chance encounter in the wilds, she would not have heard his stories of the Northmen. And she would not have this chance to find Dillian's soul.
Holy shit, that was cool. That was badass. Well, alright guys, I'm gonna call it there. It's been, what, a good 3-hour stream? So yeah, it's a good place to call it immediately after a boss. Instead of, you know, getting to a boss and then calling it. That'd be bad, come on. But anyways, I'm gonna call it there for the night, and I'll see you guys later. Have a good one, guys. Bye.